Hey everybody, this is Adam Gussow from Satan and Adam, and you notice anything different? Yeah, that's right, I didn't shave this morning, no. These sunglasses, see these things? These are what I use when I'm coming back up Old Sardis Road on Sunday morning when it's probably 75, 80 degrees, Mississippi, July, trying to get my 16 miles in, you know, crazy. Okay, so it's hot here, it's very hot, but no matter. Your harmonica master has decided to give you a series of lessons about third position harmonica playing. Now, the last four lessons I gave were on first position. Third position. What is third position? Why do you want to do this? Why must you do this? Why must you master this? I'm going to give you kind of like the idiot's guide. This is directed towards beginners, early intermediates who've somehow managed to stay away from third position playing. I'm going to give you the quick and dirty guide, because I think that what you've got to do always is leverage the knowledge that you have playing cross harp. I'm going to take these off. They're annoying. The leverage that you have playing cross harp, right, you got to take all that knowledge and you got to milk every last little bit of extra out of it. And you can do that third position. So this is what I'm doing. I've got two harps. Well, I've got a few harps with me. I'm going to start off on an A harp, okay, and then I'm also going to play a C. I'm going to show you how to play third position in both. We're going to work from the ground up, and I'm going to talk about holes on the harp, and I'm going to talk about licks, and I'm going to talk in interval terms. In other words, I'm going to use things like the fifth, the minor third. Okay, it's important that you get that much theoretical knowledge, so it's time to, you know, go off and find that, and I'll try to explain it as I go along. Okay, let's start. I've got an A harp. What key would you normally play this A harp in if you wanted to play blues? Well, until my last series of lessons, you'd say E, right? And you'd play cross harp. Like Sweet Home Chicago. Okay. Train Time, remember Jack Bruce did? Wonderful harmonica tune. Okay, lots of stuff you can do on an A harp. Cross harp. In fact, it's very important to master that. Now, we know you can play first position on this A harp. You can play in what key? First position on an A harp? That's right. Some of you guys are smart, right? You've been saying, you're shouting A at the YouTube. Okay. A, first position. So you can play blues, and I showed you last time. Or you can play on the upper register, as Jimmy Reed often did, as James Cotton does. And notice I'm doing the blues scale there. The octave, flat seventh, octave, flat seventh, fifth. And then I'm gonna roll off that fifth. It's all first position, flat five to blue third, to tonic note. Okay, forget all that. You got this A harp, and the band, for some crazy reason, decides they want to do, well, a slow blues in B. And you don't have what key harp. What key harp would you want to play cross harp in? Well, if you wanted to play cross harp in the key of B, you'd need an E harp. I like E harps, actually. We don't use them too often. I think Midnight Rambler, talking about a Midnight Rambler, Mick Jagger. I think Miss You, I think Sugar Blue, who played with the Rolling Stones on that cut. Okay, so an E harp's a good harp. I used to play that when I was playing in the streets back when I was a crazy young man. Okay, so you know how to do those cross harp licks, hopefully. Excuse me while I get the camera, we're in real time. Now, what am I doing there? Well, I had a B harp. I was going to use a B harp for this lesson, but when I was playing my gig with Charlie Hilbert at the press room in Portsmouth, I spilled a gin and tonic, the end of a gin and tonic, all over a bunch of harps, and the B got ruined. I just threw it out the window into the Mississippi dusk, okay? Bad harps should be stomped and thrown away. Third position. We're not getting very far. We're already 5 minutes into this lesson. What am I going to talk about? Okay. Let's think. Let's begin by leveraging what we know cross harp. So I've got an E harp and an A harp. The E harp is to play cross harp in the key of B. And I'm going to go 2-3-4 draw on this E harp. And I'm going to do a lick. In fact, I'm going to do something like this. That's on an E harp, cross harp, playing in the key of B. Well, I don't have that E harp, but I still want to play in the key of B. All I've got is this A harp. Well, I mean, I could play in the key of E, but how do I play in the key of B? Well, that's third position, okay? First thing to think, know, to understand with third position is, for the time being, forget about the first octave. In other words, forget about holes 1, 2, 3, 4, or holes 1, 2, 3. Start on hole 4, okay? When you're playing, when you're first beginning to play third position, start on hole 4. That is your tonic note. Now, if you're used to the world of cross harp, where the two-hole draw is your tonic note, you got to just shift up two spots. In fact, that's actually a pretty good move. It turns out that many of the licks that you know cross harp, starting in holes 2, 3, 4, work amazingly well, transpose kind of easily, if you just move up two holes and start them on holes 4, 5, and 6. Let me show you what I mean. Get that E harp. Okay, so I'm going to do a lick. Well, I'm going to do the major triad, 2-3-4 draw on the E harp in the key of B. Oh, say can you see? That's fifth, third, root, third, fifth, octave, castrato. Okay. 4-draw, 3-draw, 2-draw, 3-draw, 4-draw, 6-blow. All right, let me try that now. So I'm going to move up and start everything on the 4-draw. So I'm going to go 4-draw, 5-draw, 6-draw. Okay, I'm going to just work with those. Well, I hear something different, right? This is the first thing to know about third position. What's the difference between E harp, cross harp, holes 4-3-2, draw, and A harp, third position, holes 6-5-4, draw? You tell me. Well, hopefully you figured out that the first and third notes are exactly the same. Excuse me. 4-3-2 on the E harp, 6-4, 6-5-4 on the A harp. Okay. Well, the difference, and it's worth a whole lesson to get this difference, is that middle note. When you're playing cross harp, that middle note is your major third. And we've talked a whole lot about how you need to pull that note down a little bit to create what I call the blue third when you're playing cross harp. Kind of a minor-y third, you're kind of flattening it a little bit. Well, the A harp flattens it for you. In fact, it flattens it a little bit more than the blues note you want, but it's pretty good. Six, so I want you to take this. Go 6-draw, 5-draw, 4-draw. And then what I want you to do is I want you to take that 6-hole and treat it just the way you'd treat the 4-hole if you were playing cross harp on this E harp. In other words, it's a wailing note. I keep on hitting the 5-draw, I'm sorry. And kind of roll off it. Now this is the E. I'm going to take the 6-draw on the A harp and do the same lick. Now, it works pretty well, right? Okay, except you got that minor third in there. The 5-draw on the A harp is a minor third. In other words, the A harp, third position, holds 4, 5, 6-draw, give you what's called the minor triad. Which makes it perfect for minor blues, okay? I can see my time's out. I'm going to have to come back with another lesson. It's hot in here. I'm sweating. I may need those sunglasses. I'll see you real soon. Bye-bye.